everyone. So welcome back for the course fluid mechanics. So in the previous class we have discussed about the total determination of total pressure and center of pressure for a horizontal plane surface, that is from module 2. So today we are going to see another plane surface, so that is determination of total pressure and center of pressure on a vertical plane surface. So here, to obtain the equation for total pressure and center of pressure for a vertical plane surface, so we'll consider the vertical plane surface, and that vertical plane surface we are going to immerse it in a static mass of liquid which has a specific weight W. So we'll just consider vertical plane surface. So this is a vertical plane surface. So what we are going to consider, and that vertical plane surface will immerse it in a static mass of liquid which has a specific weight W. So, and this is the free surface of the liquid, so we'll consider that free surface as OO, and the dimensions of this, the width of this vertical plane surface is B, so we'll consider B as the width of the vertical plane surface, and this vertical plane surface immersed in a liquid of specific weight W, and this is the CG and this is the center of pressure. The depth of the center of gravity is denoted by the symbol X bar, and the so here first is we have considered vertical plane surface of area A, and after that so we have immersed that vertical surface into a static mass of liquid which has a specific weight W, and here X bar represents the centroid of the vertical plane surface. And here see, in case of horizontal plane surface, if you considered any point on the surface, the depth was remaining same. So but here in case of vertical plane surface, see, if you considered this point, for example, if you consider this point, the depth from the free surface is different, and similarly if you consider this point, the depth is different. So here, so the depth will vary, depth below the free surface varies from point to point. So here the depth of the depth of the surface below the free surface does not remain same. So the depth will vary from point to point, from point to point below this free surface. So here as depth varies, that is H varies, so the pressure, because we know hydrostatic law, P is equal to what? W into H. So which is, so P is directly proportional to head H. So here H is not constant. So as from the hydrostatic law, pressure is directly proportional to H. So here in case of vertical plane surface, H is not constant. H is a varies from point to point. So that's why the pressure P will also vary from point to point on this vertical plane surface. So that's why what we are doing, so to determine the pressure, so earlier the pressure was constant, that's why, So we have determined using the hydrostatic law. But here, so at this point the pressure varies, at this point pressure varies. So for that, what we have to do here, so to calculate the total pressure force, to calculate the total pressure force, so what we are doing, we are dividing this entire plane surface into number of parallel strips. See, as you see in the orange color, so we are dividing this entire plane surface into number of parallel strips. So to calculate the total pressure, so what we are doing, so we are dividing the plane surface into number of parallel strips. So after that, what we are going to do, so we are going to determine total pressure force on one strip of the surface. So to calculate the total pressure force, because here the pressure varies, so because the depth is varying, so due to that the pressure also varies. So that's why to calculate the total pressure force, what we are doing, we are dividing this entire vertical plane surface into number of parallel strips, and we are going to determine, so what is the total pressure force on one elementary surface. So that is denoted by DF. So here, so whatever this strip you are seeing, so we have considered this one elementary strip. So to calculate the total pressure force, so that is elementary total pressure force DF, and after that, to obtain the total pressure force, we are going to integrate this, so elementary force, to get the total pressure force which acts on this entire plane surface. So for that, what we are going to do, so here we are going to consider this elementary strip, and we are going to consider the elementary strip, the thickness of this elementary strip as dx, and the depth of this elementary strip from the free surface is x. So we have considered an elementary strip of thickness dx with a width b. Thickness is this, this is a thickness dx of width b, and at a depth x below this free surface. So now, so what is the next step? We are considering elementary horizontal strip. Okay, it is a horizontal strip, that's why elementary horizontal strip of thickness dx at a depth x from free surface. So now we are going to calculate what is the pressure force on that elementary surface. So the pressure force on the elementary strip is, so we know pressure force F is equal to what? Intensity of pressure into area. So the intensity of pressure is what? It is W into H into A. So now what we are doing, this is the definition for the total pressure force. F is equal to intensity of pressure into area, and F is equal to P is equal to W into H. So F is equal to WH into A. So but here the pressure force we are calculating on a elementary strip, so that's why it is DF. DF is equal to what? W, and the depth of this elementary strip we have considered, so here the depth is x. So we have considered the depth of the elementary strip from the free surface H as x, and area, it is an elementary area DA. So okay, so the total pressure force on the elementary strip is DF is equal to W into X into DA. So because the depth is X, So we have considered that elementary strip at a distance, at a depth x from the free surface. So now we have to, this is the elementary force. So total pressure force is what? Total pressure force is F. So we have to calculate that F. So for that what we have to do? So we have to integrate that elementary force df. So if you consider the integration of this df, so it is w x into da. So here the specific weight is constant. So specific weight of the liquid is constant. So you can take it outside the integration. So f is equal to w into x into da. And here the integral of x into dA is A into x bar. So that is the first moment of area. So that is integral of x into dA is equal to A into x bar, because so integral of x into dA represents the moment of surface area about the free surface of the liquid, so which is nothing but area into distance from CG. So distance is from the CG is x bar and area of the surface is A. So integral of x into dA is equal to A into x bar. So where this x into dA is what? It is the moment. It is the moment of a vertical surface. So if you substitute that, so you will get F is equal to W A into X bar, so which is same as that of the horizontal plane surface. So the total pressure force, so for a vertical plane surface is F is equal to W A X bar. So next is center of pressure for this vertical plane surface. So here, so the center of pressure is calculated by using the principle, that is principle of moments. So we are going to consider the moments of this total pressure forces to calculate the what is the center of pressure for a vertical plane surface. So what is this principle of moments? So which is nothing but the momentum of the moment of the resultant force is equal to sum of the moments, sum of the moments of the component of that force. So that is the principle of moments. So center of pressure is going to calculate by using the moment principle, that is, so moment of the resultant force is equal to the sum of the moments of the components of the forces. So first we will calculate what is the moment about the elemental area. So as we have considered elemental area, so horizontal strip, which is nothing but the elemental area dA. So horizontal strip of thickness dx of width b at a depth h, which has an elemental area A. So moment about that elemental area dA is what? Dm. So dm is the elementary moment. So about, we are considering elemental area dA, that's why the moment is dm is equal to, so what is moment? It is force into the perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance, so for this area is perpendicular distance is x, so it is, and the force which acts on this elemental area is df, so it is df into x. So that is the moment about this elemental area. So moment equation is m, moment is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance is x and the force is df. So dm is equal to df into x. So the total moment, how we have done it to calculate the total pressure force? So similarly, to calculate the total moment m, so we have to integrate that elementary moment. So elementary moment is what? It is integral of, so dm is df into x, so it is df into x. So what is df? So we have calculated the df. So that is the elementary force, which is nothing but w into x into dA. So we'll substitute this here. So you will get m is equal to what? Integral of w into x into dA into x. So it will be w x square into dA. Okay, so here the specific weight will remain constant, so you can take it outside. And here integral of x square into dA. So see, integral of x into dA, that is the first moment of area, so which is equal to x into, sorry, ax bar into a. So but here, so that is the integral of x square into dA, that is the second moment of area, so which will be equal to the moment of inertia, which is I naught naught. So integral of x square into dA represents the second moment of area, which is equal to the moment of inertia I naught naught. So this I, that is moment of inertia, will vary. So for different plane surface, for horizontal the formula is different, and for circular surface it is different. The formula will vary. So for different plane surface. So here this is the moment, some of the moments of the components of the forces. So but next what we have to calculate, what is the moment, the total moment due to the total pressure force, so which is denoted as MR, that is nothing but the momentum of the resultant force, which will be equal to F into H bar, because see F acts at the center of pressure. The depth, the perpendicular distance from, for this total pressure force is H bar. So momentum of the resultant force MR is equal to F into H bar. So and F is what? We have obtained the expression, it is WAX bar into H bar. So according to the principle, we'll name this as in equation 1 and this as equation 2. So what is the principle of moments? It is MR is equal to sum of the moments of the components of the forces. So we'll equate equation number 1 and equation number 2. So which will be WAX bar H bar is equal to W into integral of X square into dA. So W will get cancelled and A into X bar into H bar is equal to what? Integral of X square into dA, where X square into dA is what? It is the moment of inertia I. So it is moment of inertia about the axis OO, about the free surface. So A into X bar to H bar. So H bar is equal to what? It is I OO divided by A into X bar. But according to the theorem of parallel axis, moment of inertia about the free surface IOO is equal to the moment of inertia about the center of gravity plus A into X bar square. So it is nothing but IOO is equal to IG plus A into X bar. So which is IG is the moment of inertia of the area about the center of gravity. So this is according to the theorem of parallel axis. So if you substitute this I not here, so H bar is equal to what? IG plus A into X bar square divided by AX bar. So H bar is equal to IG divided by AX bar plus AX bar square by AX bar. So AX bar will get cancelled. So you'll get H bar is equal to IG divided by AX bar. So this is the equation for the center of pressure vertical plane surface. So in the next class, we'll see the next plane surface.